Hello students. So in this video we'll discuss the force between two long parallel current carrying wires. Okay, and we'll show here when the current in two wires are in the same direction, they always attract to each other. Very interesting, na? It's very interesting. And when the direction of the current of the two wires are different, opposite, they will repel to each other. So see how it is possible. I'm showing. So suppose this is a wire, I'm taking a wire, and in which the current I1 is flowing in this direction. Okay, now at a distance, suppose take a distance r, okay, here, and see what will be the direction of the magnetic field due to this. Using the right hand palm rule, keep the thumb in the direction of the current. Okay, and indicate that point where you have to find the direction of the magnetic field. Obviously, it is the pushing direction. So, here the magnetic field is downward. Okay, downward direction. Okay, so suppose you have kept another wire in this field. And what is the B here? B1, due to the first wire, it is the second wire. Use the formula mu naught upon 2 pi I1 upon R, because it is due to the I1 current. No? So this is the B1. Here the B1 is produced. Clear? So now suppose the second wire and the direction of the current in the second wire is in the same direction. Okay, I2. Is it clear now? So now what will happen? See what is the direction of the force due to this wire. See what is the force. Okay, to find the direction of force, use the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, Fleming's left hand rule. This is the force, this is the magnetic field, and this is the current. Okay, so keep this finger in the direction of the current and the magnetic field downward direction, like this, and the force towards the first wire. Is it clear? This finger is the magnetic force, magnetic field. It is downward, and this finger, it is in the direction of the current. I2, and the force, it is obviously in the first wire. That is, you can show like this. So this is the force due to this wire. Okay, now come to this point, this wire, due to this current, see what is the direction of the magnetic force, magnetic field. So use again the Fleming's palm rule to find the direction of the magnetic field. So keep the thumb in the direction of the current I2. Okay, and the direction is pushing direction. It is in upward direction. So here the direction of the magnetic field is upward direction. Okay, it is in upward direction. Is it clear? Now you know the direction of magnetic field, you know the direction of current. So try to find out the direction of the magnetic force. Again, use the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, I'm showing again here. This is the force, this is the magnetic field, and this is the current. So I am showing here, keep this finger in the direction of the current and the force. This is the magnetic field. So I am showing like this. Okay, it's not easy to understand, but you can understand. Okay, this is the current, this is the magnetic field, and this is the electric current. So current direction is here. I'm showing the direction like this. Okay, magnetic field like this. Magnetic field, this is in the direction, and this is the direction of current. I think now you can understand. Okay, it is the left hand rule. This is the B, this is the I. So keep the, I'm showing this line second. Okay, this is the I, and this is the magnetic field. And what is the direction of the force? It is towards the second wire. Is it? So this is the direction of magnetic force. So you can see here, both are attracting to each other. Both are attracting to each other, and the wire will bend like this. Okay, like this. Both will exert a force on each other. Is it clear? So you can find a formula also. So force, what is the formula? The force is equal to here I2, the force exerted on here I2, B1, this is the magnetic field B1, and take the length L. Okay, take the length of L. Sine, it is the 90 degree everything, so you can write. Okay, now put the B1 value of the B1 here. So I2, I2, and B1 means mu naught upon 2 pi I1 upon R. It is the L. Or you can write mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R L. This is the force. This is the force. And one more thing, interesting thing. If we change the direction of the current, okay, expression will be same, remain same. Suppose this is the I1 and suppose this is the I2. Now, what will happen in this case? I'm showing again. First of all, see the direction of the magnetic field due to this wire. It is downward direction in I2 here in this wire. So it is the downward direction. It is downward direction in this wire. Now, due to this wire, see the current is in this direction. So I'm showing like this. Okay, this is the direction of the current. So here, direction of the magnetic field in this wire, it is the again downward direction. It is again downward direction. Is it clear? I think clear. Okay, they are separated by a distance R. Now see what is the direction of the force. Okay, I'm showing here first I, this is the B, this is the B, this is the I, this is the force. So this is the I, I'm showing here I. Okay, and the magnetic field downward direction, magnetic field downward direction. So what will the direction of the force? This is the direction of force. This is the direction of force here outward. This is the B, this is the B, B, and this is the I. Okay, so force is in this direction. And similarly here, see, for this wire I2, this is the direction here, see, this is the I and this is the force. This is the magnetic field. So magnetic field downward direction and this is the I. So what is the direction of the force? It is the outward direction. Okay, so use your left hand rule. This is the force. So what will happen? The force is outward direction like this in this case. So they will repel to each other. Remember students, if the direction of the current is in the same direction, they will always attack to each other. If the directions of the current in both wires are opposite, then they always repel to each other. Okay, and the force is given by this expression, or you can write F upon L is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. That is the Newton per meter. This is the force exerted per Newton meter. Okay, and if I1 is equal to I2, then we can write F upon L is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I square upon R. Okay, this is the desired expression. Now students, you can explain, you can define 1 Newton and 1 Newton current also. That is the standard definition. So how can we define using this formula? Okay, if you know mu naught upon 2 pi is equal to 2 into 10 to power minus 7, already you know this value. Okay, Newton per meter you can write. And if you take R is equal to 1 meter, okay, then I is equal to, and if I is equal to 1 ampere, then we can write F upon L. Everything is, suppose this is the 2 into 10 to power minus 7, and this, it is the 1, it is also 1. So what is this? It is the F upon L is given by 2 into 10 to power minus 7 Newton per meter. I think it is clear. Take this value, 2 into 10 to power minus 7, take I is equal to 1 ampere and R is equal to 1 meter. So it is the F upon L is equal to 2 into 10 to power minus 7. So Newton per meter, it is equal to 2 into 10 to power minus 7. Now, how can we define 1 Newton, 1 ampere current? So, I writing the definition, and it's very important. So 1 ampere is the current. 1 ampere is the current which when flowing in each of two infinitely long parallel conductors 1 meter apart in vacuum, we are writing the standard definition, vacuum produces between them a force of exactly 2×10⁻¹ newton per meter of the length. Okay, so per meter wire will exert a force on the second wire equal to 2×10⁻¹ newton. Okay, so this is the standard definition of the 1 ampere, very important for your exam. Thank you, students, for this.